So we won the die roll, and I'm gonna choose to draw first. Feel like an extra card will help us in our strategy of not mulliganing and then curving out with lands. This is a reasonable start. We don't have any of our dual lands, but we're only missing green mana. It's not vital that we get Smoke Teller down as soon as possible. We do have debilitating injury to get things going, and then Abomination of Ghoul. And this will ramp us into hopefully an early Necropolis Fiend. Ideally, we don't want to delve at all for Murderous Cut. Real awkward draw by us. I don't have my mind made up on incremental growth. Like, it's a fantastic card, but maybe this isn't the deck for it. We only play 12 creatures. It's just such a backbreaker, and it could really save us later, but as is, our mana is bit awkward. Leaping Master. We can take care of that later with incremental or with debilitating injury. What is this? Debilitating injury. Sweet, we drew a forest. But right now, I would rather play a Morph because then we're not wasting a mana this turn. Next turn, we can play debilitating injury and Smoke Teller. Which should put us in a pretty reasonable position. It doesn't appear that we're going to die in the early game. And our hand's set up pretty nicely for the long game, so. Abzan Banner. Sweet. Alright, so this is interesting. We could play two 4-drops. As badly as I want to flip this immediately, I also want to just. I'm obsessing over never wasting a mana. So my thinking is basically we had two options. Could play the Blossoming Sands over the Smoke Teller so that we could flip the Abomination next turn. But then we would waste one mana this turn and not really advance our board in the way we want. Alternatively, we can play Blossoming Sands and Murderous Cut next turn, be way ahead on board, and then we can start doing this. This also opens up the door for us drawing a basic land and then flipping. We do want to start hitting with this as soon as we can because we, as good as all the cards in our hand are, we want to fuel delve so we can get this guy out. Like, this guy is must kill. He's huge. 3-1 prowess. Yeah, I didn't play any of the like delve enablers, but I didn't want to play them in sealed with a 40 card deck. Like, I don't want to deck out. I'm playing control deck. We're playing control deck. Sweet. I don't want a murderous cut. I want to do this. You know, we have initiative at this point. So, I'm gonna. Actually, I don't want to trade the Smoke Teller since we have this incremental growth. I don't think there's anything the opponent can have that can kill this right now. And getting one hit in is great. Good chance we discard the incremental growth, though. Like, we only have the two creatures. And I imagine Blossoming Sands is what we want because it gives us double green, and we do want more lands for this. Alright, let's do this draw. Let's pitch Smoke Teller. It's just not exciting. Nice, and now our graveyard is. I'm debating this attack. Because we might not even be able to block here. Pretty unlikely, though. 3, 4, 5, 6. Man, this deck's pretty sweet. Cutting Treasure Cruise makes me sad though. Savage Punch, so it did miss an attack. plus two plus two. Wait. How did this work? Tarkir control. I missed two damage. Also, he or she did not fight the abomination, which they could have, in favor of getting six damage in, but I'm pretty happy with that. Abzan guide, fantastic. So we can pitch this incremental growth, which I actually don't like very much, and I probably want to get rid of it. 2, 3, 4, 5. And we could play Necropolis Fiend this turn if we wanted. Which is probably a safe bet. I like pitching the banner. What's the banner or incremental growth? Incremental growth is not that exciting right now, but it could be a pump kill out of nowhere for the win. And I'm not certain how I like the banner, although we could like... this is a tough situation. Opponent could have Smite the Monstrous, I would expect. We could pitch incremental growth. Actually, I am going to pitch incremental growth. Is that right? I don't know. It's hard for me to explain this play other than I'm making the play that never wastes mana and always advances our mana. That's basically the deciding factor in all these plays. So we just advanced our mana and everything worked out perfectly. And we still have these. I don't want to waste the Murderous Cut. 13 life, we seem safe enough. I would be tempted to gain life as well. Not going to block. I don't think we're going to die. Probably going to flip this for life right away. It would have been reasonable just to get the Fiend down, but I didn't really want to, I want to draw out removal if we can. Mardu, War, Shrieker, sure. Opponent gets to do two things. Pretty exciting. We can play Murderous Cut and flip this, which is probably the play I'm going to make, and then still have this Necropolis Fiend. Oh, Burn Away. Oh, that's a huge blowout, because that exiles our graveyard. Wow. And killed that thing. We could play Murderous Cut. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We can't play Necropolis Fiend. I would rather just flip and gain 4 life. That was a tremendous blowout, though. And would have given points to having played the Murderous Cut. White, green, black. But I didn't wave up the right mana for Murderous Cut, but we can't play it anyways. Play Jungle Hall. We're still in a good spot. We're at 15 life. We're ahead on board. Reasonably even on board. And we have a removal and a bomb in our hand still. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But glad to get rid of the incremental growth. I think I'm going to cut it from our deck. I think this is a great card for certain decks, but I would rather just have another morph creature, I think. Either the 5-5 or... yeah, probably the 5-5. Just keep splashing them. Alright, that's a lot of damage, and I'm concerned about Smite the Monstrous. But if Smite the Monstrous is a thing, then we'll have the Fiend left over, and we should find out about it before damage. 3, 4, 5. Abzan, Grizzly. Interesting. So, here's two options. We can Murderous Cut the Grizzly and attack, but if this thing gets hit by a kill shot, that would be insanely bad for us. So I'm going to offer a trade, and then play Necropolis Fiend. That leaves us incredibly vulnerable to removal, though. Still have a chance to rethink this before damage. So, Yeah, smite. I don't think the opponent has smite the monstrous. This was probably just a bad attack. Should have just kept that back on defense, you know? That was actually really bad, I think. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That seemed like an embarrassingly bad play. Well, I don't know. There's something to be said for just getting the life right now. But that thing made a great blocker for both of these. And I just made us vulnerable to smite the monstrous when we didn't have to be. Although, this was probably going to have to trade with one of these two anyways. I didn't like that last play I made, but we're here now. I'd like to play a perfect game, but now I just have to hope that that isn't the difference in the game. Have to play around cards like Act of Treason. Are we going to get Smite the Monstrous? Not Smite the Monstrous. Great. Outlast. Nice. Okay, well, the opponent has some good stuff out, but what am I missing here? We can just block, right? Can and should. Block this 3-3. Am I missing anything? It doesn't seem that way. It's just suicide attack, yeah. Opponent's tapped. I might have just let him in if the attacks had happened earlier. Am I missing something? Like, we still have this murderous cut, but with the opponent at 8 life, it's tempting to just turn this sideways. Yeah, here's what we can do. We're at 10 life, 3, 6, 7, 8, and we have a murderous cut. So alternatively, we could use this to kill that, and use this to kill that, and it's just this versus that, which is fine. But since the opponent is at 8 life, has nothing, I'm pretty tempted to just end the game right now. This leaves us vulnerable to a top deck removal spell, but since we don't have another threat, the longer the game goes, the more that's true. This forces the opponent to top deck something next turn. Neither of these go flying, do they? Trample and lifelink, okay. And 3, 6, 7, 8. I'm gonna wait on the murderous cut, choose a target. We should be able to, should be totally fine waiting. Get the banner down. I'm gonna cut the incremental growth. This thing, is this an uncommon? That thing was crazy. And here's this murderous cut I've had since the very beginning of the game, which has been available to play all game. I just am a big fan of saving the removal spell for creatures we have to kill, and we haven't had to kill anything to win this game so far. Burn away. 6 damage is a lot. Alright, last turn. Opponent top decks. If it kills this, then our goose is probably cooked. 3, 4, 5. Do we need to be concerned about burn to the face? Weird. I'm glad the opponent didn't attack with all, because that would make for a difficult decision. Has the opponent drawn a kill shot? I'm gonna crack this Soul Tide banner. And we could fire this murderous cut off, but see what we draw. Nice, Red of the Serpent. 3, 4, 5, 6. Get a 1-1. I guess I'm gonna fire this off and kill the 4-3, and then we can Red of the Serpent the other one. And we'll have mana to play whatever we draw. Just want to play this really safe. As safe as can be. Mystic Monastery, that can let us cycle our Tamir banner. See if there's a kill shot waiting for us. A deflecting palm. Tension is high. Wow, actually. Wow, that was the actual draw. I could've, at this point, like, could've, that's so annoying. That's pretty annoying, you have to admit. At this point, I could've used it to kill that, but then I would've get smited in response, because we only had one thing to remove. Okay, well, we can knock this off, and then we have a 1-1 facing that 3-1. I did miss 2 damage earlier in the match from that non-attack. I'm not really sweating the no trade. Well, it's tough to say. This game could have been played in a million ways, and I think that's the beauty of it. Like, I have a style and a strategy, and that's what I'm going with. 3, 4, 5, 6. Opponent's only drawn 6 lands, going through 17 cards. So, the longer the game goes, the more they are due to flood out. Also, the worse our villainous wealth is. This is a crime. This is a crime that this has been drawn. Tamir banner. Losing this game is going to feel so bad. These were the consecutive draws from the opponent. And these are our draws. Three. Our deck is half mana, to be fair, and it's possible the opponent's not playing very much, but they're playing, like, they are playing 4 colors as well. Three. Yeah, we're gonna have to chump block and then top deck something amazing. This game was definitely winnable by, for instance, not just passing with the Necropolis Fiend to play around Smite. Yeah, like, I could have played around a top deck Smite there, played Rite of the Serpent on one, and then tapped to kill the other. But do you think the opponent would have just smited it before we could do that? And probably would have. And here's a swamp. God, this is Control Z. Green, blue. I would be pretty unhappy to lose this. Green, blue, red. Gotta wait to draw a card. Is it alright if I draw a card, opponent? Sultai Flare. So this can basically let us chump for one turn. And then maybe we top deck Villainous Wealth. Or the thing that draws, like, looks at 7 cards. We've drawn 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 lands, which is mostly about expectation. Okay, well, hopefully we trade here and gain life. Wait, we're just dead. Never mind, so we lost. I'm pretty unhappy to lose this game. Villainous Wealth is the next card, and then let's see what we still had on our deck. We had bombs on top. Jeez, yeah, come on, man. Well, this is Magic. Like, you, sometimes games slip away. And that probably made for a great game for the opponent, so suck it up and try to win the match. I still feel favored in the match. I'm going to cut Incremental Growth just for another thing that we can for sure morph. Which is this. We can do it for 3 mana, so worth playing. At this point, we could play Mardu banner over a Tamir banner. But I'd rather have a green-blue like our main colors. And then got to look at, we don't necessarily need removal. Yeah, we fought it out and lost to the long game with, like, bombs in our deck. God, that felt so bad.